Hello, everyone, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. Welcome back to my UMass Dynasty in NCAA 13. When last we left off, we went to the U of M, Minnesota, and beat the Gophers on the road to become 2-0. It's time to go back to our recruits here and try to work some magic, including number 2 overall quarterback Isaac Stover. Also, center, number 1 overall center Tremaine Daniels. He's considered a bust in scouting, but not to us. That 75 overall would look really good on our starting offensive line. He's probably a long shot as well, as you see Alabama and Auburn ahead of us. Joe Walker, number 1 tackle. Again, he's a minus 4, but a 70-80 grays out even after that. Yeah, we'll give it a shot. Like I said, these guys are kind of in our long shot category, just as Charles Smith was last year. But we made a good run at him, and we almost got him. So now to more realistic issues. We need a free safety. Ernest Spicer is one that's on the board that's interested in us. We're number 2 on his board right now. Lee Harris, we're number 4 on his board, but we could definitely make up some room there by offering him a scholarship and some promises. So there you see, getting some major points with him. Eddie Galloway, defensive end from Maryland. Remember, I'm trying to open that pipeline in Maryland by getting one more recruit in, I believe, from Maryland would do it. Corey Harvey, another one of those Maryland players. So I'm checking those guys out, hoping to get at least one of them to come in and add that extra pipeline state. So Joel Meadows. Somebody asked me why I don't recruit in Massachusetts. I do. Joel Meadows right there. He's from Massachusetts. And I believe that, looking at my pipeline stats, at least 20 of my players are from Massachusetts, so I don't know why that was mentioned when it's not the case. But it is time to play now, and if you came to the live stream yesterday, you saw this live. If you didn't, well, buckle up, because we got a pretty good game coming up. Rival Boston College comes to town. Now, they're 0-3, but don't let that fool you, because Boston College is a pretty tough team, especially for a team like UMass, to take on. So we'll have to see how this goes, but just remember that we've got a lot riding on this, because I pitched to just about every recruit. I've gone all in on having a winning record against rivals. This is the only game we have against a rival team, so pretty much do or die here. So we got to get a win for the recruits. Do it for the recruits. So here we go. Collins is going to hand off to Jim Mitchell. Not much going on in the first play of the game. He's only going to get a yard. Second and 9 now. Wesley Collins is going to take the snap, and he's going to throw quickly to Ronnie Houston, who makes the catch. That 6-7 frame boxes out that corner and makes a catch. Third and 1 now. Jim Mitchell will get that first down. It'd be really nice to have a successful first drive and punch in a score here, take a lead. We always seem to play best when we can get that score first, obviously. Most teams would probably say that. Jim Mitchell, another run there. Now on 3rd and 4, Collins, a very quick drop back, and he throws to Fossell for the first down. That is Blanche Flowers' replacement there, and he's doing very well for himself wearing that familiar number 87. Playing the role that Blanche Flower did for this team, making big third down catches and doing a good job there. So Wesley Collins gets the defense to jump offside on that play, which is nice, making it a free play. They like the result of the Jim Mitchell run better than the 5 yards that they would have gotten on the penalty, so they just take the run. Next play, handing off to Jordan Broadnecks, and the game freezes. That'll happen sometimes, but Jordan doesn't get discouraged. He still runs out to the right-hand side for good yardage. Now 1st and 10, Collins can't really decide what to do here and takes a sack. Probably should have thrown the ball away, but this is a big play for Boston College's defense. Look at that guy. My goodness, what a beast. Landing on Collins there. So we got 2nd and 19, and we got to try to relieve some of this pressure. They do bring the blitz up the middle, and we go to the screen to Mitchell to the left-hand side. He's in the end zone for a touchdown. Great call. Good timing for a screen. They brought the blitz up the middle. Like I said, we go to the outside. We take care of who we need to. Blocking wise, and Jim Mitchell's 94 overall speed does the rest, getting into the end zone, and it's a 7-0 lead for UMass. Just like that, got a lead. Notice the crowd's a little bit bigger today. Yep, that's starting to fill in there as we win some games. Kimball gets this handoff and is going to get a first down on 3rd and 4. So Boston College looking to strike back themselves if they can get a series of plays together here. And this pass is going to go to the tight end, who does not want to go down. Doesn't get much for yardage, but goes out of bounds with that catch. We got play action right here, and a wide open Evans makes the catch. Nice play right there. That gets them down to the 25-yard line of UMass. Here comes a blitz on the left-hand side, but nope, he's able to complete the curl route right there. It'll be second and inches. Bordner's going to throw again. Just lobs that nicely. And look at him. Oh, man, the big tight end, Darmstadter, just gives that guy a shove. Says, get out of my way. And right into the end zone. This guy is one formidable tight end right here. Look at that. Nope, you're not tackling me. Made him look silly there on his way into the end zone. This game is tied at 7 as the Eagles punch it in. So back to offense. Wesley Collins calling the plays here. Going to hand off to Jim Mitchell. He's going to fight for 5 yards outside to the left. Now we got a pass play on 2nd and 10. What's Collins going to call? He's going to go to the slant to Houston. He makes the catch, but wait. No, it's lodged out. Is it a fumble? Incomplete pass? Interception? They're saying interception, meaning he caught this before it hit the turf. Let's see another look at it. Ronnie Houston dragged down awkwardly there and loses the football, but now the question's going to be, did he catch it or did he trap it on the turf? Junk Johnson's actually going to call for a coach's challenge here, and we're going to see another couple looks at it. It's really close. It's really close. Let's see. Oh, well, I don't know. Maybe he did get it. Maybe he trapped it. It's hard to tell on our angles. It's sitting right above the turf. And when it's all said and done, no conclusive evidence to overturn it. So it is a huge turnover here at the 20-yard line. And BC looking to get in here. The pass to Scott is going to go for a decent yardage now. 2nd and 8. Going to hand off to Kimball. He spins. And he's going to get hit, but not until he gets positive yardage. Now 3rd and 3. What are they looking for? A wide open tight end once again. Yep, there we go. That offense is just not having much problems moving the ball on UMass here, and it definitely helps when you get a turnover right inside the red zone there. So we got to try to avoid that from here on out. We pretty much gave them one. 14-7 is the deficit, and there's 1:20 before halftime. Collins patiently waiting for someone to get open, and that's his tight end Fossell, who does rail this in and gets good yardage. Here we go now, 3rd and 10. Collins, oh, that's not a good throw. Okay, well, they've forced us to punt here. Not good. We wanted to answer before halftime. So on comes our punter to send this one away on 4th and 10. It's a very high kick. Patton did a good job getting it up in the air. And why doesn't fair catch? I don't know. And he fumbles it. It's on the turf. UMass has the ball. Talk about big turnovers. There's one right there. A fair catch would have avoided the whole problem, but instead, we've got UMass and Collins getting to jump offside again, meaning free play. It's going to be knocked away at the back of the end zone, but it wouldn't have mattered if they picked it off. BC was offside, and UMass can accept the 5-yard penalty and the do-over on 3rd down. What do they do on 3rd and 5? Well, they look short to Fossell again, and he makes the catch. That's great because it gives him a 1st down. Now under 40 seconds left and Collins has another chance to the end zone, and it's Fossell again. This time, Pater for the touchdown. Oh my goodness, he's happy. Junk Johnson's happy. The whole sideline's fired up, and this crowd is loving that UMass just got themselves back into a tie. Let's watch the throw. Wesley Collins accurate right there to Fossell. The tight end makes the catch without much aggravation there by the defense, and it's 14-all. Into the 3rd quarter now, Boston College with the ball. Bordner is going to fake this, and he's about to throw. Oh, he's got all sorts of time. Where is he going to go with the ball? Look at this. He's going to heave it deep as his wide receiver comes back. That was pretty good coverage forever, but no rush means that those wide receivers break off their patterns, and one eventually is able to work back to his ball. And look at him just chuck this up. Wow, that's a big gainer for BC on a broken down play. You know, coverage can't hold forever. So on 1st and 10, Bordner is going to throw much quicker this time. And it is to Evans for, well, not quite a 1st down. It'll be 2nd and 1. But they are knocking right at the door inside the 5-yard line. Hand off to Kimball. No one's going to even lay a hand on him as he walks in for the touchdown, protecting the ball. BC up again, 21-14. This goes back and forth, and we've got an answer down in the third quarter. Wesley Collins gonna throw to Fosell. Just as Ronnie Parker dominated the first game, you see Fosell doing great work here in the tight end position. So Wesley Collins on second and two out of the shotgun. Gonna find Jim Mitchell, who releases out of the backfield and makes this catch for first down yardage. First and 15, as the offensive line jumps offside, they set up the screen again. And it looks like it may be successful again. Jim Mitchell down the sideline to the 40, to almost the 35. We'll give maybe the 37 there. Great play on the screen once again. And this time they really brought it, the pressure right up the middle, and it allowed this to set up outside. They seal off their blocks and let Jim Mitchell get down the sideline. They're at the 35-yard line. So let's hand off to Mitchell again. Fullback in front of him. He decides to go outside. He's got first down and more. He is down to about the 12. Jim Mitchell now 55 yards on just 7 carries. Second and 13. After a run play that didn't work well, that we went to the screen one too many times, and it was absolutely shut down by big number 99. He had a sack earlier, and he's all over Jim Mitchell on this play. Great defense right there by BC. So third and 19. Now they got to come up with something different. They got everybody spread out wide. Look at this ball to Houston. Ronnie Houston runs under it. Oh, my goodness. Wesley Collins has a great throw right there. Led him into open space, and Ronnie Houston does the rest. Touchdown, UMass. And Houston is beside himself, excited. Look at that. Look at this throw by Wesley Collins. He threads it over the head of two BC defenders, but far enough where only Ronnie Houston is going to run under that. 21-all as the fourth quarter starts. More play action for BC. More wide open plays for BC. Spiffy Evans, you got to love that name, makes the catch, and he's been a big part of the game today. So Bordner to throw again. Over the middle, Scott's going to get it. Short of first down yardage, but then he runs for well more than he needed for first down. So third and 7 now. Bordner, can he convert again? Well, he's going to throw to the end zone, and he's wide open. Smith left him open, but he drops the ball. What a favor there. BC's going to try a long field goal. My goodness, they could have had a touchdown, and now they get nothing as that kick is short. Didn't look like the best kick in the world. UMass holds. It's 21-all, and they got a chance to drive the field and maybe end this ball game. So let's hand off to Jim Mitchell. Go to the left-hand side. He fumbles. Oh, my goodness. Ronnie Houston is right there to pick it up, or this could have been disaster. Look at this. Jim Mitchell is met and separated from the ball. Ronnie Houston falls on it, luckily, or picks it up anyway. BC's got a bit of a problem in the play, too, as Jeremy Morris is down on the field, linebacker, in some considerable pain. As a matter of fact, they'll take him off on the cart as he gets a little bit of a round of applause from the UMass crowd. So here we go. We got second and 12, and Collins to throw, and it's picked off by Borsich. Oh, my goodness. This drove me nuts in the live stream because I thought I had led him to open space, but now watching this back, I see the problem. Wesley Collins throwing off his back foot, momentum going the wrong way. I tried to lead that ball to Ronnie Parker into open space, similar to the touchdown to Ronnie Houston. Instead, throwing off the back foot produces a weak throw and an interception, and we've got major problems now as BC is driving for the go-ahead score. What do we do here? We got two timeouts. You're at the position where you almost let them score. Well, they run quite an elaborate screen right there that gets them right to the goal line. I'm not going to call timeout here, and I'm essentially, you see me backing off at the nose tackle position, letting them walk in here to preserve the two timeouts and a chance to come back and tie this. So BC does score after the turnover, and it's now 28-21. 2:09 left, two timeouts. Wesley Collins has to be careful here. He's going to roll to the right, and he's going to throw. Ronnie Parker makes the catch, gets a foot down, and out of bounds. Nice play by Ronnie Parker to get open. He's been relatively quiet today, but he is still very dangerous to get himself open and make plays like this. So UMass has to continue moving here, second and 11. What's the play call going to be? It is shotgun. It's Wesley Collins to Fosell again. They've been doing a great job matching up these two. It's another pass to Fossil and another first down. So Collins again feeling a little heat, but he gets the ball into Fossil again. These two are just on the same page all day. First and 10 now from inside the 40. Collins going to throw quickly again. This time it's Ronnie Houston. They dive, but to no avail. They can't catch him. He's in the end zone. We've got a tie ball game if we get the extra point. Look at this. Houston, we have liftoff towards the end zone. There goes Ronnie Houston. Gonna score, and the freshman showing off here. Here we go. Gotta love it when we've got this comeback ability here, this two-minute drive ability with this team that we have not seen in years past. Bordner now brings his BC team back, lofts that one to Miller. He just has that nice soft touch, getting balls in there to people, leading them well. He's played really well today. He's gonna get a blitz on him, and he's hit, but not before he gets the ball out to the right-hand side here. They get 9 yards. Oh, if we could have gotten to him and gotten a sack, that'd been a huge play. Second and one now, under a minute left. Trying to bring some heat again. They're going to go deep. And it's picked. No. Oh, he dropped it. It could have been picked off. And oh, what a huge play this would have been. Instead, it's knocked to the turf. And it's never a bad thing when it's an incomplete pass. Except, oh my goodness, Smith. You could have had a pick there. I hope that doesn't come back to bite us. Let's see what happens on the next play. We're going to have a third and one. And we need to make a stop. They're in the shotgun, so they're not going to go with the short run. Instead, Bordner is going to stand tall. Ed loft that one to the sideline. That's a great catch, getting a foot down. At least I think he did. Let's see. Another great pass. And his wide out will get at least 1 foot in bounds. That's a great catch. Really clutch there on third and one. I'm surprised they didn't run the ball, but they went for the pass. Second and six now, and we can't give up much more in territory here. Or, well, we just did it. We're looking at no timeouts left now that we've called a couple of our last ones. Wait a second! The one thing he couldn't do, he fumbled! Powell picks it up! We've got the ball! We avoided a certain loss. They were just going to center the ball and kick a field goal, but instead it's on the turf. We picked it up. Let's do this, UMass. But hold on a second. We have a booth-initiated review. And they look at it, and they come back, and they say that he was down before he lost this ball. It's very close, folks, very close. But it looks like, yes, indeed, he might have been down before the ball came out. They get the second chance to kick the game winner. Oh, my goodness, even that wasn't easy. He sneaks it in with 2 seconds left. It's a 31-28 lead. We want this kick to go out of the end zone. If they're smart enough to kick it that deep, they kick it short, we let it go, it still rolls out of the end zone. We have 2 seconds left. We have a series of offsides calls on the defense. Here's one of them, jumping offsides, but they did not allow us to go for the free play. I wanted to be able to stamp that ball, a little irked at the refs not letting the play continue. There's a big number 99 jumping offsides. He's had a good game, but we moved 10 yards forwards just by two of those. It's Hail Mary time. We got to have something happen. Trying to get him to jump again. I want that free play. I want to just take a shot deep and get the penalty if it doesn't work. But it's picked off right here. Oh, that's Louis John. I think that's the guy who's a beast in Burns' dynasty for BC. I remember him having 3 picks one time early in his dynasty. Well, in this one, he comes to bite me. And BC pulls it out. Oh, my goodness. This is not going to be good for our recruiting. We bet the farm on beating rivals. We offered that promise to just nearly everybody we've gone after, present and past. Josh Bordner plays a heck of a road game at quarterback and gets himself a win. Well-deserved. UMass, they fall to 2-1, and they got some explaining to do to their recruits, to their players that they've already recruited. Hopefully nobody will jump ship because of that. But it has been a big pitch since we don't have a lot to pitch on. Come on back next week as we play the next week in UMass Dynasty. See you then.